Good morning, Knights.
On today's show, we talk to Diamondbacks fans about the World Series, meet this year's favorite teacher, and go behind the counter at our local smoothie shop.
Don't go anywhere, because this week's episode of The Studio starts right now.
Cracking Nights, I'm CJ.
And I'm Cooper Sneed.
During the summer, one of our students, Carson Wengert, received a Nestle scholarship and had the opportunity to visit Taiwan. Aislinn and Lana have the details.
Many students wish to travel the world, and Carson Wengert is using his Mandarin skills to make it happen.
My name is Carson Wengert. I'm a Nestle scholarship recipient for the year 2023. The Nestle scholarship is a language immersion scholarship program. They do lots of different languages that they deem critical security languages. So Mandarin Chinese is one. They do online summer or an entire school year's length. And I went over this most recent summer to Taiwan. In Taiwan, I was taking classes at a university with some teachers that they had arranged, and I was in classes with a bunch of other students from around the U.S. We were staying in a dorm for 4 of the 6 weeks, and then we stayed with host family for the last 2 weeks, where we got to experience more daily life.
Miss Leatherby has always been there to help Carson expand his knowledge.
Oh, of course, I'm proud. And I always encourage them to go beyond the classroom and apply the language outside of the classroom in real life. And hang out with the people who are passionate about foreign languages, I think is a great learning environment for them. Language is a subject that you have to use it. So that's the time we encourage them to use the language outside of the classroom. I'm a big believer that language and the culture are together and it helps the students grow in the language and the culture understanding.
Being fully immersed in Taiwanese culture allowed Carson to enhance his language skills.
Going to Taiwan definitely improved my language skills a lot. Understanding the culture of a people whose language you're learning to speak will really help you to learn their language better overall. I'd say with the daily life experiences in Taiwan, it's an awesome place to be.
If you're taking a foreign language, consider entering competitions. You might just end up traveling the world like Carson. This has been Aislinn and Lana reporting for The Studio.
Last week, club pictures were taken for the yearbook. The yearbook staff would like to express appreciation to our teachers for their patience and understanding as students stepped out of their classes throughout the day.
Jack and Matt recently visited with senior Bryce Borrell about his passion for fashion and customized slides. Here's the story.
My name is Bryce Borrell, and I like making shoes, clothing. I also have a cat, his name is Sol, and sometimes hates me. I make clogs, usually, you know, like the Birkenstock ones that like are extremely popular. I just put like my own like little design on it. Usually it's just for me, but like the brand that really inspired these clogs, I would say, was probably Chrome Hearts and Elite. Chrome Hearts is like super famous for like that cross pattern, so I really wanted to add that on there. It was just black on black. I love how Elite did their chains with like the locket, I guess you would call it. I just love both of those brands, and I saw like those designs, and I specifically Elite's chain, I was like, I need to do something with that lock.
I asked Bryce what people think of his work.
A lot negative, a lot of positive. You know, anytime you make something, no matter how good you think something might be, you're gonna get kind of negative and a ton of positive with it. I did post showing off the shoes on TikTok. It's at like 11,000 views right now. I know to me, like that's not like that much, but like I got a lot of comments like just, oh my God, like when can I get a pair? Or like when are you gonna be selling? Even just like one comment, like that first comment I got just made me like feel so good about myself.
We asked Bryce to explain why he has such a love for fashion.
I just love how everyone gets to be themselves. Like literally no matter what you're into, you can be into like humongous heel boots that look like if you trip and fall, you'll break your ankle in. If you're into it, you're into it. You know what I'm saying? Like you don't see anyone else going out wearing those. You know what I'm saying? And everyone that wears those, like you're gonna be going outside, and everyone's gonna be staring at you. They might be saying hateful stuff. They might be saying good stuff. But like no matter what it is, like Fashion, I think, brings out the confidence in people that they can't get, like, literally anywhere else, no matter what.
Last week, the Kiwanis Key Club took a field trip to the Arizona State Fair, where they had the pleasure of spending the day with children who have special needs. It was an incredible experience for all who participated.
To celebrate Dia de los Muertos, the Spanish classes created sugar skulls. Each sugar skull represents a departed loved one and is usually placed on an altar or gravestone as an offering to the spirit of the dead.
Yesterday, just following second period, a boxing match broke out in the courtyard. Sir Nightmare took on Williams Field Chicken and once again won by knockout. Be sure to come to the game tonight. It's a wideout. A few Higley students have recently started working at Pliables, a local acai and smoothie shop in Queen Creek. Kylie and Brianna decided to learn more about what it's like to work there.
Pliables is a local hotspot that attracts many students. So we caught up with a Higley Knight who works there to see what it's all about.
My name is Addison Visegli and I'm an employee at Pliables. Pliables is a local smoothie and smoothie bowl shop. We're located out on Ellsworth and Riggs in Queen Creek. I've been working at Pliables since last March, so it'll be a year this spring. My favorite part about my job is people that I work with. There's a lot of Higley kids who work there, and so it's fun to just be in an inclusive and supporting environment. My favorite item on the menu at Pliables is probably either our green base, which is made with bananas, pineapple, kale, milk, or our coconut base, which is also really good.
We took a Higley night to Playa for the first time. Here are her thoughts.
My name is Macy. I'm a sophomore at Higley, and this is my first time at Pliables. My first initial reaction was just seeing the decorations, you know, how the place is decorated. It's like a tropical, beachy type style. They have a lot of surfboards and plants and lots of fun colors too. I would definitely say the workers separate this place from others. You know, they're super kind, they're really helpful.
Macy decided to try one of their amazing acai bowls to see what makes this place special.
This acai bowl, I would rate 9 out of 10. It's got good flavor. I love the strawberries and the bananas and the fruits. I would definitely want to try smoothies next time, or, you know, because they have so many options.
Definitely go and check out Pliables down on Ellsworth and Riggs if you want to try out some great smoothies and bowls. This is Kylie and Brianna signing off of the studio.
The Armory is now open during both lunches. Stop in for some refreshing drinks and tasty snacks.
In today's fast-paced world, we're bombarded with countless questions. And one of these questions might be, is a hot dog really a sandwich? If you've ever found yourself struggling to find the answers to questions like this one, stay tuned. The solution may be waiting for you in our next video.
Hey, Knights. Me and Trevor caught up with some students to ask some controversial questions.
All right, we're here with
Seth,
Jackson,
with Luke,
and Dylan.
Dylan,
Javon,
and we're gonna be asking them some questions. Let's go. First off, should pineapple be on pizza?
Yes.
No, you're an idiot, bro. Why are you putting a fruit on a pizza?
Because it tastes good.
Pineapple is sweet. It does not go with the savoriness of the pizza.
But some people like the sweet, savory taste of it on the pizza, and that's what I am.
It's homework educational.
I think homework's good to do, but it's not always, it shouldn't be like requirement. But like whenever I do it, I feel like it's good. I get something out of it.
I think homework can be good, but when it's just busy work, it's horrible. Just doing the same thing over and over again, there's no point to that.
Yeah, no, if it's just like repetitive, there's no point in it. If it's like something like in class, Mr. Hong, he's a goat.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
No. Yes. No. Maybe?
Yeah, classify it as a sandwich, you know, sandwich, you just put meat in between like two buns. Like a sandwich, like the bread can be considered as buns, then that's exactly what a hot dog is.
But it's a different type of meat.
Doesn't matter if it's a different type of meat.
If you think it's a sandwich, you're wrong, because it's a taco.
Definitely a sandwich, same thing.
All right, Knights, that's all for this week. This is Abe and Trevor signing off for The Studio.
On Wednesday, Victoria Lithgow held a ceramic workshop to craft mugs for this winter season. It was an enjoyable time for all those who attended.
Honestly, it just needs to be a small, thin piece, just so we can finish.
Hey, Knights. Exciting news. There's a brand new club on campus, the Christian Club. It's a great place to explore and enjoy the Christian faith while having a fun time with fellow students. Join them to be a part of this enriching experience.
Two former Knights, Jonah von Neumann and Mikey Velez, discovered a passion for photography while studying at Higley. Today, they are taking the skills they learned into CTA classes and using them to launch a photography business. Jonah and Mikey are two former seniors from Higley. The CTA courses they took helped them start their venture into photography.
I'm Jonah von Neumann. I'm a photographer. I went to Higley last year.
My name is Mikey, and I used to go to Higley. Now I do photography as my thing. I honestly got into photography just by seeing the awesome stuff you can do with cameras in Mr. Noodle's class. Didn't have anything really much to do as like a passion or like a side hobby. So cameras kind of just gravitated to me.
I've always liked taking photos and film and movies, and taking video production really let me indulge into that world of working with cameras, working with editing and filming, shooting. And
like any other hobby, the equipment is a crucial part in the process.
So I have two cameras. I have this film camera that I have on my neck. This camera was made in 1967, so it's actually pretty old. I use this because I really like film, and film is just, it's a raw version of photography.
With like a digital camera, sure you can take like a bunch of photos, just upload them into your computer, but there's something you're gonna get with a film that you can't get with a digital. Finding a spot is really the most crucial part about doing photography, because you gotta make sure it matches the person you're taking the photo for.
Once you just work with it, you work with the photo, you work with the frame, you work with the subject, a lot of it is just creative stuff, so it's not too bad.
To them, photography is more than just a side passion.
With photography, I hope to take it as far as I can take it. Honestly, I wanna build a business out of this. I wanna keep taking photos and like actually make money off of it.
I plan to make a career out of photography. If it's filming, editing, actual photography itself, I would be happy doing anything. Instagram is Kaleo Film. If you want to follow me on Instagram, if you ever want to photo shoot, hit me up.
Again, if you want to get some flicks, check out at Kaleo Film on Instagram. This is CJ Ping signing out.
The D-backs totally nailed it with a huge win against the Phillies last week, advancing to the World Series. Well, things haven't gone so smoothly this week. Just being in the World Series is an incredible accomplishment. Roman Avienna checked in with a few D-backs fans to get their input.
Coming inside, that's where the target is set for this 3-2. Moreno hits it in the air to left center field. Tavares and Carter on the move. That ball is gone!
Hey Knights, I'm Roma.
And I'm Avienna.
With the D-backs making it to the World Series, we went around and asked some of your Higley Knights their predictions for the game. Are you a D-backs fan?
Yes.
Heck yeah.
Yes, I am.
I went to one game.
Yes, I'm a real D-backs fan.
Name one player on the D-backs.
Are you guys a fan of the D-backs?
Absolutely.
All right, what's one player in the D-backs?
Tyreek Hill. Like Devin Booker.
Neil Armstrong.
Corbin Carroll.
Ketel Marte.
Corbin, I forgot his last name, but it's Corbin something.
John Lennon.
John Lennon?
Name one player on the D-backs.
Me.
No, I'm just kidding.
Have the D-backs ever gone to the World Series before?
Probably. Yeah. Yes, in 2001 when they won it with Luis Gonzalez Grand Slam.
Do you guys know if the D-backs have ever gone to a World Series before?
Like one, 10 times? 10 times?
Ooh, I think it was like late 2000s. They won with Randy Johnson in the purple throwback jerseys.
What is the Diamondbacks mascot?
Oh shoot, a snake.
It's a bobcat.
It is?
It's Baxter.
No.
Yeah, that's
isn't it a snake that's
like a snake?
Dumb.
It's a bobcat?
Some type of bird?
A duck.
Baxter.
It's the Baxter.
Baxter.
Unfortunately, the D-backs did lose the World Series, but we still have some great D-backs fans in campus, some not so much. This is Avienna and Roma signing out for the studio.
This week was Spirit Week. Monday was Dynamic Duos. Tuesday was Trick or Treat. Wednesday was Mathletes versus Athletes. Thursday was W's All Around. And today is Whiteout. See you all at the game tonight.
Elliot and Ryan recently sat down with freshman Isaac von Neumann and senior Keegan Potts to share what drives their musical passion and hopefully inspiring others to pursue their own musical talents.
My name is Isaac von Neumann and I'm a freshman.
I'm Keegan Potts, and I am a senior.
Isaac and Keegan are two profoundly talented musical artists here at Higley who share their devotion to the arts of guitar and drums.
I've been playing guitar for around almost 10 months. I started playing in the beginning of February. My biggest inspirations are probably a few of these indie artists, Mac DeMarco, Steve Lacy. A lot of them are really big inspirations. I like the way they play. The advice I would give somebody getting into guitar is probably to just be patient with it, because when you first start off, it's a little tricky to understand, like reading tabs and getting your fingers used to it, but after a while, you do get used to it and it becomes really easy. Playing guitar is all about like consistency, so if you're really good at playing something constantly and making it sound good, then you're a really good guitar player.
Playing instruments with consistency seems daunting to many. However, Keegan shares his difficulties and how he's conquered them.
The hardest thing was the mental blocks. When things got really hard, I typically liked taking really long breaks and didn't give myself enough time to practice, but pushing through those was the hardest part. If you're trying to get into drums, don't worry about the equipment you need. I remember when I first started, I always wanted the equipment that all the professionals had, but all you really need is some drumsticks, something to hit, and some music you want to play.
With their unique talents allowing them to be recognized as the best, both knights urge many to pick up an instrument, not only as a hobby, but as an artistic form of expression. This has been Elliot and Ryan, signing out for the studio.
This week and next week are soccer tryouts. Come out and show off your skills.
Our yearbook staff recently welcomed a new teacher to the program, so Vaughn and I stopped in to meet her and see how this year's yearbook has been progressing.
My name is Jennifer Acra. I teach the graphic design and the specialized design and the book production at Higley. My past experiences with graphic design and yearbook, the last 10 years I've been doing yearbook at a junior high. The graphic design aspect is new this year to me, but it's something that I'm very familiar with in a way.
My name is Zach Kilby. I'm a senior this year. I am the editor-in-chief of this year's yearbook. My past with the yearbook started in sophomore year. I did the intro to graphic design class, had a blast, and then last year I was just a normal staff member and we pushed out that yearbook. We almost missed our deadline, but we got it done at the end of the day.
However, this new role comes with some inevitable changes that Ms. Acra must face.
The challenges for this class that I've run into is about coming in mid-year, and that was a challenge. Getting to know everybody, you know, with any teacher, we'd like to start this year off at the beginning.
So the process of creating our yearbook is at the end of every year we start talking about theme, and then we make the cover, and then we make the end sheets, which is basically the inside of the book. It's not an actual page.
Future plans for the yearbook, bringing kids ideas in, changing things up, just having a different production to it, different themes, and every kid has a different creativity and we'd like to bring those all together.
This class has taught me some amazing things, from the design aspect and how to take photos, to how to make friendships and how to be a leader.
Overall, it seems like this program will continue working to make the yearbook better than ever before. This is Cooper and Vaughn signing off for the studio.
Well, that's all for this week.
The studio is off for next Veterans Day, but we'll be back the following Friday. So, have a great weekend, Knights.